Hello, a very good afternoon and welcome to the Circuit of the Americas in Austin, Texas, as some paddock personnel tried to put me off as best as possible there. Welcome, it's the Red Bull Grand Prix of the Americas. We are here live inside the paddock, Jack Appleyard, to talk you through what's been going on inside this pretty special, pretty buzzing paddock, I have to say, always. Very, very special occurrence to be able to come here to the USA, our one and only visit, which means it's a bit of a landmark event. A couple of characters to chat to, none other than a MotoGP legend very shortly. Before that, though, let me introduce you to someone whose music you'll be very familiar with by now. If, like me, you've been humming along to it and as an earworm, it's got into your mind and you can't help but go to bed singing the song. I have to listen to it a lot. This is Marco Beltrami, the composer of the brand new MotoGP theme tune. First of all, congratulations. It's a huge hit. And tell us about the story behind how all of this came to be, because you yourself are a huge fan of the sport.
Yeah, I mean, thank you. So it's a real honor to be here and I'm so excited. I mean, I've been to the Oscars, but this to me is more exciting. it's like just as exciting, but without the fancy costumes, you know. I've been following the sport for a while, and I was thinking, because I'm always thinking emotionally and sort of about characters and all that, that it needed something to, they're almost larger than life figures, and something that if there is a way to musically express that, I really wanted to do that. And so I contacted Frank and he liked what I sent, and it went like that. So it was a lot of fun.
How long was the process to put this new theme tune together?
It was pretty quick. It was probably about 3 weeks.
Wow, 3 weeks.
Yeah. Well, I started with an initial idea and we refined it. You know, they had some suggestions and things that initially it sounded a little too Western. And I think that's because I think everything I do is a Western. But so I had to refine that a little bit. But then there was three segments too, you know, and having them all tied together. So they're all sort of based on the same idea. But there's, you know, the segment B, which plays, when you start talking. And then there's the segment C, which is for the podium.
Very nice. And talk to us about your love for the sport then. And where did it all start? I imagine, like most, with a certain Valentino Rossi.
Rossi was always amazing. I mean, watching this old Rossi, you know, Nicky Hayden and Casey Stoner battles and all that. I was totally hooked. And I knew that if I wanted to ride, I had to get my son involved, because it's the only way I could take, you know, get a hall pass to go take, you know, time to go to the track. And we have our own little riding club, and so to see the real pros do this is just it's amazing.
You've just been watching up at turn one, I think. So
it's amazing, and to see the speed, to see how they negotiate, you know, how they bring it in, like almost like a V, and then get on the gas, and the little bumps that you don't see when you're watching, like being right there, the little bumps at the top of the track and coming around the turn. To be here like a few feet away from it, I'm in heaven.
Picked up any tricks or tips from watching that first practice when you next get back on the bike?
Yeah, just don't let off the gas.
That's always a plan. Keep it pinned. It helps in any scenario. Exactly. Marco, absolute pleasure to meet you. Here for the weekend, I imagine?
Yeah, going to enjoy all the races, so I'm so excited. And it's a pleasure to listen to you. I really like listening to you.
Thank you, I appreciate it. Before I let you go, we need to get a prediction off you. Who are you fancying this weekend?
Yeah, I know. I knew you were going to say this. I really think Pecco is he's got the fire on him now because of Marco Bezzecchi. So I think it's going to be him.
Bagnaia's going to fight back this weekend. So. I think I agree with you as well. Okay. Absolute pleasure. Enjoy the rest of the weekend. Great to chat. I'm just seeing, is there someone behind us? Oh, it's a certain Jack Miller. Let's have a quick chat with Jack, if we can. Lots of fans here. Jack, of course, loves this place. On the podium twice in his last three visits. First time here on the KTM, though. So it'd be good just to grab a quick word with him once he's spent time with the fans. Selfies here, selfies there. few signatures as well. I think in the end, top five for Jack in the opening practice session. And Jack, one of the good guys in the paddock, has always got all the time in the world to be able to chat to everyone, which is great to see as he makes his way through. Let's see if we can grab a word. Lots of fans here, as you can imagine. But I'll squeeze in shortly. Oh, good, Jack. How are you?
Good luck tomorrow.
You love this place. Competitive in the past, but first time in a KTM. So how was it?
Yeah, it was all right, apart from two crashes in the same corner. Little ones, but and both on outlaps. Can I give you that, Tommy? Both on outlaps, but apart from that, I mean, we were in the top five this morning. That's what we wanted. First roll out here in Texas, the bike's working pretty decent. We got a little bit of adjusting to do, but happy to be competitive from the first session.
And you were pretty confident that the bike, the maneuverability of it, was going to work pretty well around
it
here.
It is, yeah. No, it's fantastic through that first sector, and we're doing a really good job through the second sector and down the back straight. So really, really happy with how things are going so far. See what this weather will do. You know, we're inside that top five, so it can rain if it wants, I don't mind. But happy to be just back here in the States racing. It's awesome to be back, and even better to be on a KTM.
You've been a busy boy in between here in Argentina. Got to the Supercross. I'm sure you were desperately trying to get a bike off someone.
No. One of those boys is next level, and you know, it's a pleasure to go and be fortunate enough to go and watch those guys do what they do. Yeah, we've been busy. Ruby and I have done a little road trip out to Nevada and then across to Phoenix and
Disney as well, right?
Yeah, yep. Did Disneyland before the little one comes along, at least, you know. So we can say mum and dad have been there at least. But it was good. Great time out here in the States. It's awesome coming back every year.
Any photos of the pair of you on any roller coasters?
No. I mean, we went on Easter Monday, so as you can imagine, it was mayhem. So a couple of log rides in the Jungle Cruise for us. I think that was about it.
Keep it nice and calm. Save the racing for here. Jack, great to catch you up. All the best for the rest of the weekend. There we go. Jack Miller is a log flume man. I thought, you know, high octane, loves to entertain. We would have seen him as a bit of a thrill seeker, but, you know, he's got those polarizing personalities. Off the track, nice and chill, nice and calm. But then when he gets on the bike, as we said to Marco, his life motto, keep it pinned, as always. Augusto Fernandez here, let's grab a chat with him and catch up. We've got Augusto Fernandez Senior to the left, who's got a good tan actually as well. I think he might have been spending some time in the sunshine. Augusto Senior looking very well. And Augusto, first opportunity to try the MotoGP bike here around COTA, which is regarded as the most physically demanding circuit in the entirety of the calendar. So I'm sure it was a real pleasure. Augusto, over your left shoulder, just quickly. How are you doing? Okay?
Oh, good. You?
Yeah, not bad. I'll let you make this signature. We're just saying, COTA regarded as most physically demanding circuit on the entirety of the calendar. You sweating after that one. How was it on the MotoGP bike?
Yeah, tough. A tough one, especially because all the bumps are not helping us to ride. And the track is, I think, is demanding. The layout is demanding, but even with the bumps, it's not easier. So but good. Not so bad. Just learning the track, learning the lines, learning how it is with the MotoGP. As you said, it's very hard, but let's see who can improve.
What do you get up to in between here in Argentina? Do you go home or spend some time in the States?
Yeah, I went home. I love to spend some time at home, even if it's a short time, but it's nice to be home.
A couple of days in your own bed, you can't beat.
Yeah.
Cheers, Augusto. Good to chat with him. And now, we promised a MotoGP legend. I think we've got one here. I'm just going to squeeze in. He is in the middle of a bit of a debrief here. I hope he doesn't mind. Let me just pop my head over and chat. Wayne, do you mind if I just have a quick chat, if that's okay? He's just chatting away. Apologies to interrupt. We're live at the moment for an opportunity to chat with one of the greats of the sports. How are you doing?
I'm doing well, thanks.
Absolutely great to see you here. How much are you enjoying being back in the MotoGP paddock?
It's been a few years. There's a lot of old friends here I haven't seen in a long time. It's nice to, you know, feel the paddock again. It's quite high intensity, but it's good to be here.
And what do you make of how the season's unfolding at the moment? As a Yamaha man, it's not particularly going Fabio's way, but looked pretty competitive this morning.
Well, you know, I think the way I think they're probably approaching is the first couple of races are kind of the It's the start of the year. It's kind of bonus races, but the real racing starts when they get back to Europe. So any points you can get, if they're good points, certainly helps with the momentum going back. So, you know, without Marquez here, I think it's anybody's race now.
Absolutely. Would the sprint races, would that have suited you back in the day?
If that's what we had to do, of course it would. So I think, you know, thinking about it a little bit, if I had to race a sprint race or the GP distance, if there was points available, I was going to try to get all I could.
Absolutely, and that's how you win world championships. In terms of the world championship this year, how do you see it panning out throughout the rest of the year?
Well, it looks like Ducati's got a pretty good bike at the moment. The Yamaha looks like it's got a little bit of work, but it looks like they're getting closer. I think the Honda's the one that's got the most work to do, both with the bike and getting the rider healthy. So I think, right now it's like if it's not a Pecco on the box, it'll be another Ducati. So it's up to the other manufacturers to chip away at that part.
Absolutely, they're all chasing at the moment. Thank you very much for your time, appreciate it. Enjoy the rest of the weekend.
All right, thank you.
Great to chat with Wayne Rainey here at Alpine Stars, who of course have got a huge presence this weekend, as ever, but even more so now, and right on cue. Johan, just very quickly, P3, not bad.
No, not bad, not bad. Never know if it's raining or not, so it was good to be quite fast with the soft rear tire and a tough track, and we all know it. They try to fix it, but they cannot do it. So we adapt, but it's always tough. The toughest of the year, I think.
And I saw on social media, was it a couple of days ago, you had that amazing clean shave done. How long ago was that? Because I'm already seeing a bit of a stubble coming back.
It's the French barb is a strong one. So I don't know when was it. It was Tuesday evening. I shave, and it's just staying 3 days. So maybe tonight or Saturday night, I will be clean for my bike for the big race.
Superb. And you had the chance just quickly to train with Romain Grosjean as well. I guess a nice opportunity to catch up with him after what will have been a few years.
I didn't know him. We knew each other by another friend that I'm working with, and the opportunity to be in Miami. I came to him, and it was great. His family is really a super family, and we got a good time, even playing golf under the tropical rain. That has been maybe the most funny. He pushed me on the tennis because he played better tennis than me. And also cycling, he's cycling pretty good, but he's missing a bit the mountains.
Good man, Johan. All the best for the rest of the weekend. Just finally as well, let me see if I can grab a word with, who are we looking at here? Fabio Quartararo's in here with a couple of local celebrities. I love this guy. I'm a big fan of Palace. I own quite a few bits and pieces. Just chatting away with, I think this guy's got about 3 million YouTubers. Fabio, just quickly, Fabio. A short one question. He's running away. But regardless, hello, how are you?
I'm doing good, you?
Yeah, very well, thank you. I was just explaining to the viewers that you are YouTube sensation.
Yeah, yeah, I'm how a many, YouTuber from Mexico.
How many followers, subscribers, sorry?
5.9.
Not bad, not
yeah,
bad.
5.9 million, yeah.
But you know, you spend a lot of time. You were here in 2021 and yes. 2022 as well with Fabio, with Jorge Martin. How much do you love coming
exactly.
here?
Exactly. It's like a second family. It's become like a second family. The ambience here is amazing. People are super lovely. So it's a pleasure to be here in Austin once again.
Absolutely. Who's your pick then for Sunday? Since you've got so many friends in the paddock, it might be a difficult one.
I'd rather not say, but I wish all of them have a great race and that they go out clean and they all have a great result.
Top man. I was just in Mexico, actually. A lovely country. I was at Puerto Escondido.
Oh, that you chose a nice destination.
Fantastic.
You should go if you haven't gone.
Yeah, absolutely. I recommend it. Sunshine, beaches, beer.
Exactly. It's got drinks, boom, nice weather, a little bit of party too, surf. Everything.
He's got everything. That's why I've got such a golden look this weekend. Thank you.
And you.
Great to catch up. And who else have we got here? Oh, Jake Dixon. Ah, with Neil Hodgson as well of BT Sport fame. Look at these two characters. We'll finish off just very quickly. Sorry to interrupt, guys. Can I just have a quick word with the new dad?
Hey, how big are his arms? Look how big his arms are.
Have you been in the gym, Neil?
shall I relax?
Look at you, you've been tense. Look at that.
Not tensing at all. I'm not. What?
That's impressive stuff.
Don't talk about my muscles. Look at you, all lean and slim.
Are you cold?
Mate, have you been in the media centre? It's absolutely freezing.
Although it is. Sorry, UK. Now, like, obviously travelled, well-travelled, so he's like coat.
Man of the world now, Jay.
Man of the world.
Anyway, how are you? I can see the bags under your eyes.
No, I'm good. Sarah's been so good to me. I've been sleeping. She's not been sleeping. So, it's teamwork. Like anything.
What's dad life like?
Hey, basically, I'm a born natural. I couldn't believe it. I just woke up and I was just, it was just so good.
I've got Neil over the shoulder here, shaking his head, thinking, I've never heard a load of more rubbish in my life.
I've been round, so I've already met Summer. And it went like this. Jake turned up because he'd been out for a run, walks in, sits down. Poor Sarah's there, juggling everything.
Fuck him.
We are watching BSB, literally pointing, ordering.
No way was I doing that. Hey, but where Neil's got man boobs, she tried latching onto Neil's man boobs. So it's a bit embarrassing, really. So I think he needs to work out a little bit more.
Mate, they're pecs. They're not man boobs.
Hey, it's embarrassing. It's not. Look at him, their chest out.
Loves it. Absolutely loves it.
You've caught us at a time where you're not going to get anything sensible out of us.
No, but that's the whole point. I don't want anything sensible.
Yeah, it's completely standard. Anyway, dressing like this, like you're going to the North Pole, is not very good, mate.
Well, do you know what? I started this 15 minutes ago and was all right, but now I'm sweating a little bit.
I see him just trying to, like, undo it like this. Just
sensual. Yeah. In the best way possible.
Exactly, mate.
Anyway, all the best.
Thank you very much.
Glad to see you doing okay.
And obviously, to all the dads out there, if you need any advice, listen, I know...
Yeah, don't contact him.
I've been a dad for 10, 11 days. I'm an absolute pro, yeah.
Anyway, well done.
See you, mate.
Hope it continues going as well. Cheers, guys. There we go. Nice way to end. Daddy Dixon giving it his best. But yeah, in all seriousness, don't contact Jake on Instagram if you want any advice on how to be a father. Right, let's finish it off. There's lots of people about here, including Jonas Folger. I'm just going to quickly squeeze in just one question just to see how we got on. I'll be very quick. Jonas, sorry to interrupt. Can I just ask a very quick question? Welcome back. Great to see you. How was that?
Yeah, it was a tough one. You know, it's been a while since I was on the MotoGP bike. So, as you know, I replaced Paul. And, it was a tough one. You know, we have to first find the position on the bike and, you know, to get used to the track. Last time I was here was 2017. So, yeah, I will make big steps the next trainings, hopefully.
Absolutely. Great to see you back anyway, and all the best for the weekend. Good to see Jonas Folger back on the MotoGP grid, as we said. Replacing Paul Espargaro for this weekend and maybe into the future as well. Right. I think, Didi, all good? Shall we wrap up? There we go. Friday afternoon, inside the paddock, officially done and dusted, chatting to MotoGP legends, stars of MotoGP, YouTube sensations, the best dad in the world, according to Jake Dixon, and another MotoGP legend as well in Neil Hodgson. Bjorn, all good? How are you?
How are you doing? Good, you?
I'm good, mate. I'm good. How was Brad this morning?
That was not too bad. We snuck into Q2 there, so that was that's always the goal, I guess, P10, just by the skin of our teeth. But I think we can make some good improvements, or Brad will make some good improvements going forward in FP2.
Top man. Enjoy. Good to catch up with Bjorn. British Super Sport legend there as well, just to add another one to the mix. Right. Thank you very much for joining us. It's been a busy one. Don't forget, tune in tomorrow, same time, inside the paddock, for another spectacular here from Austin, Texas. See you later, guys. Bye.